Hello, yes, it is I, the pink of the cowboy, and today is the first video that I'm making ever. So that's interesting, right? Yes. So if you don't know me, I make horror films and thrillers mostly, a mix of the two. But I've been wanting to dabble in some video essays, explaining my favorite movies and just like analyzing them, giving them reviews. And so this is my first video, and I'm super excited to see where this goes. I think this will be something fun to do. So yes, let's do it. From the iconic opening sequence of the first film to the self-aware and genre-defying introductions in the sequels, the Scream franchise has always had a knack for grabbing the audience's attention from the very beginning. In this video, we will take a closer look at the opening scenes of each film and discuss what makes them so effective.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes?
Who is this?
Who are you trying to reach?
What number is this?
What number are you trying to reach?
I don't know.
Well, I think you have the wrong number.
Do I?
It happens. Take it easy.
The opening scene in the first Scream film is now a classic in the horror genre. It features Drew Barrymore as Casey Becker, a high school student who receives a phone call from an unknown number.
What? Hello?
Look, I gotta go.
Wait, I thought we were gonna go out.
Nah, I don't think so.
Don't hang up on me.
The caller, later revealed to be Ghostface, engages Casey in a game of horror movie trivia before revealing himself and attacking her.
It's an easy category. Movie trivia. I'll even give you a warm-up question.
Don't do this, I can't.
Name the killer in Halloween.
No.
Come on, it's your favorite scary movie, remember? He had a white mask, he stalked the babysitters.
I don't know.
What makes this scene so effective is the way it subverts the audience's expectations. Drew Barrymore, a well-known actress at the time, was prominently featured in the marketing materials for the film, leading audiences to believe that she would be one of the main characters. By killing her off in the opening scene, the film establishes that anything can happen and that no one is safe. Okay, besides the original Scream movie, this is one of my favorite opening scenes. The Scream 2 opening follows a similar structure to the first film, with Jada Pinkett Smith playing Maureen Evans, a college student attending a sneak preview of the film Stab, a movie based on the events of the first Scream film. As the movie plays, Ghostface appears in the theater and begins to attack Maureen. Once again, the film plays with audiences' expectations, using the fictional film Stab to create a sense of confusion and disorientation. The scene also sets up the themes of the film, with Maureen being a vocal critic of the horror genre and the way it portrays women.
Why'd she gotta be naked? What does that have to do with the plot of the story, her being butt-ass naked?
I also think this one is just very like scary because it's like the first time we really see like a bunch of ghost faces like in the series, like all in one location, like Scream 6, like the train sequence. So this is just like, it has that feeling of like, he's here, but which one is he? And to me, that is terrifying. It's the fear of the unknown.
Talk about
The opening scene of Scream 3 takes a different approach from the first two films. Instead of a prologue featuring a victim, the film opens with Cotton Weary, who survived an attack in the second film.
Cotton Weary.
I do, huh?
Yeah, I think he's got a really sexy voice.
Oh, well, thank you.
Wait a minute, you are Cotton, aren't you? Oh my God, I am talking to Cotton Weary. I can't believe this.
In this opening sequence, Cotton Weary is lured into a trap by Ghostface. This scene serves as a continuation of the previous film's story and establishes Cotton as a major character.
Stay back! Stay back!
Chris, what's going on, babe?
You've gone crazy, that's what!
Chris, was somebody in the house?
Come back!
Okay, just calm down, okay?
Why do you want to kill me?
What are you talking about?
Why do you want to kill me?
Give me the club, all right, honey? Give me the club. Christine, get out of the way! Oh! Behind you!
It also sets up the idea that the events of the previous films have had a lasting impact on the characters.
It was a simple game, Cotton. You should have told me where Sydney was. Now, you lose.
The opening scene of Scream 4 is perhaps the most self-aware and meta of all the films. The scene features Anna Paquin and Kristen Bell as characters discussing the rules of horror movies and how they apply to the current generation of horror films.
Fucking kidding me. What? That was so fucking stupid. Pure horseshit. The death of horror right here in front of us. Even the opening scene, there's always some random girl who gets a call that undoubtedly ends up getting her killed. It's also predictable. There's no element of surprise. You can see everything coming.
Did that surprise you?
Why?
Because you talk too much. Now shut the fuck up and watch the movie.
Oh my God, I love it. I've seen it 5 times and it still gets me every time.
As they watch a fictional horror movie within the movie, Ghostface appears and begins to attack them. The scene plays with the idea of rules of horror movies established in the first Scream film, while also commenting on the state of the genre in 2011. The opening scenes of the Scream franchise are some of the most memorable and effective in horror movie history. From the subversion of audience expectations in the first film to the self-aware commentary in the fourth, the franchise has always been adept at setting up the themes and tone of each film. The opening scenes also establish the idea that anyone can be a victim and that no one is safe, adding an element of tension and unpredictability that keeps audiences on the edge of their seats. Yeehaw! So, if you like that, let me know in the comments what your favorite opening is. 1, 2, 3, or 4. Mine would have to be number 1, the opening of the original. And also, I would say probably the second movie as well. That one is just, it's just iconic. I just love a movie theater, and it was just very melodramatic, and it's great. I have not seen Scream 5, but I plan to. I have seen 6, and I could talk about that opening, but I feel like I need to see 5 before I talk about 6. So maybe this will be a part 2 of 5 and 6, and maybe by the time I actually make a video, 7 and 8, 9, and 10 will be out. I also wouldn't be appalled by the idea of analyzing the Scream series on Netflix, I believe. If you would like that, let me know in the comments as well. Until next time, cowboys and cowgirls and cowthays, see ya, yeehaw!